Hello everyone. In this session, we'll discuss about Java program. Okay, so first lab program, that is 1E. Actually the subject code is 18 CSL. Okay, it is not 15 CSL, it's 18 CSL. The syllabus is same. So create a Java class called student with the following details as variables within it: USN, name, branch, phone. Write a Java program to create n student objects and print the USN, name, branch and phone of these objects with suitable headings. So since they have said what it's a n student object, means what you need to create the object of the class, right? And how many what are the inputs now, what are the variables now to be used: USN, name, branch and phone. These are the variables. Yes, so now first here you need to accept the data details of students from the keyboard. Okay, then display it on the screen. So that is the aim now. Yes, so first execution always starts from main method. Here you can make use of these import packages, two packages. Okay, that is java.io.io exception, means what if you make any errors, so that will be displayed. Okay, and then java.util.star. So this is to, what is that, this is because we are using scanner class here. Okay, java.util.star, you can use star or you can also use instead, replace the star by scanner. Okay, well, that is one and the same. Okay, so since we are using scanner class, you had to use this package import space java.util.star. okay, so even if you don't use this IO exception, it's okay, you'll get output. So it is just to display what the error message if you while entering, for example, the variable. If the variable is what if declared as integer, and if you try to enter some different values, then it will display that what is that errors, why has that error occurred. It will display that on the screen. That's it. Okay, next here, first execution always start from main method. So where is main method? It's here. Okay, so class lab 1 is what class name, which is a main class. Why it is a main class? Because it has main method, right? So execution always starts from main method. So first we are creating the scanner class here. Scanner class is what it is, it is used to, what is that, it has the method next int. Okay, it has the next int method. Okay, so what is the use of next int method? To accept the characters from the keyboard. Okay, since we are using next int method, okay, so this works only if you pass system.in as a parameter for scanner class. Means what? Because system.in is what it is used to accept the characters from the keyboard. You can give the inputs from the keyboard only, then only what you can accept the user input from the keyboard. Okay, then here you are just printing the message system.out.println, enter the total number of students, and here int n is equal to in dot next int. Next int is what? Next int is non-static method of, next int is non-static method of scanner class. Okay, to access non-static method next int, we have to create the object of scanner class. Okay, so now using this object in, yes, you can access the method. So using in and dot operator, so in dot next int. So when you enter your inputs from the keyboard, that will be stored in variable n, so which is declared as int. N is declared as int. So student, and here we are creating an array now. Here we are creating the array of student. So what is the object here? St. And so this is what declaration, we have declared the object. So what is the use of new operator? To allocate memory. What, see, for example, you will be entering it. when you create an array, obviously you'll be storing the data, right, in the array. So to allocate memory, you had to store it in the memory, right? So to allocate the memory, you are using new operator. So new operator allocates memory for the objects. Okay, that object contain variables or data. Yes, so that is why we are using new operator here. So then after that, string USN name. So now we are here created the sorry, we are just declaring the variables. Okay, so as string, data type is what? String. Next, so here we are using for loop to accept what details of students from the keyboard. Yes, so we have to create, because how many times it has to be there in the loop. So it depends on the number of students, right, that you are going to enter. If n is equal to 5, say n is equal to 5, here at this stage I'll enter the value of n is equal to 5. Okay, so when pointer is pointing to this particular line, it will wait for user to give the inputs. Then after that, once you enter 5, it will take that input and store it in variable n. So now n is equal to 5 now. So what is the value of n here? N is equal to 5, right? N is equal to 5. So I is equal to 0, I less than 5. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 5 times it will be there in the loop. So next after that, now we are here, we are just printing the message, enter the details of student. 0 plus 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how many times? 5 times it will print. So first after this, first iteration it is 0 plus 1, 1. Next here US it will just print the message, and here it will wait for user input. At this stage it will wait for user input again. So next is what? Next is non-static method. Next is non-static method of scanner class, which is used to accept user input. Okay, which is used to accept user input. It could be integer, character, whatever. Okay, special character. So and how am I accessing this next inbuilt method of scanner class? Using object of scanner class in. Instead of in, you can use your own name, that is user defined name. In is user defined name, but you have to use the same name here, so that whatever the value you enter will be stored in variable usn. Yes, and then after that here you are creating name again, so you are accepting the name from the keyboard, and similarly accepting this one branch from the name, from the keyboard, accept phone number from the keyboard, user input as user input, and here we are creating the object of student one class. Why am I creating the object of student one class? So here in order to store the data, okay, you had to see why am I creating, because as soon as you create the object, okay, here we are creating the object of student one class. As soon as you create the object of student one class, you already know which block gets executed, constructor block gets executed. So you have to define a constructor here in a separate class. Okay, so just create a constructor. So which is constructor in this class? Student one. This is the constructor. So student one is a constructor which is declared as public. Means what? This constructor can be accessed outside student one class also. That is the meaning. And here we are passing the parameters. What are the parameters? USN name, branch, and phone are the parameters. And these, for example, say first I'll enter USN one, name A, branch IS, and phone number 123. And these are the parameters I am passing now. This will be assigned to U, N, B, and PH respectively. So again, this U will be assigned to USN, PN will be assigned to name, PB to branch, phone to PH to phone. Okay, so now this is what these are not private variables now. USN name are not private variables. These are what? Public variables. So because they are declared as public, means what? These variables can be accessed outside the class, outside the student one class. That is what we are doing here. So here we are printing it out. So student details. So just this is just for format purpose. Okay, format sake. And here we are printing the message. Again, you have to make use of for loop in order to print the message. So system.out.println. Yes, so these are what non-static variables, right? USN, name, branch, phone are non-static variables. Why non-static variables? Because we have not used static keyword here. Yes, public static string we have not used. Since if you don't use static keyword, then it is a non-static variable. In order to access non-static variables or non-static method, you have to create the object of that particular class, that is student one class here in this case. So using this, it's already created, right? Student one object, object of student one class is already there. So you make use of this student one object and access the variables USN, name, and branch and phone of which class? Student one class, and print it here. Okay, so how many times it will be in the it will be in the loop? 5 times, because while entering the data we have entered 5, n is equal to 5. So again it will be same. So let us execute this. We'll see the output. Okay, so this is the program. Yes, I'll just execute this program and then we'll see. Run. So a number of students. I'll enter 2. Okay, and USN 1, name A, branch IS, phone number 123. Yes, a USN 2, name B, branch ECE, and phone number 234. So this is what the output, right? Student details. That's it. It's all about 1A program, right? Means what? Just accepting inputs from the keyboard and display it on the screen. Hope you understood. If you have any doubts, you can comment below. Thank you so much for watching.